Okay, class, we are going to start our session today. And last time we had done tenses, but we had not done in a very detailed way. So there are the attendance is low. So I'll do one thing. We are going to do comprehension first. Okay. By the time others will join, and then we will do tenses. Fine. I'm going to
Okay.
give you all a comprehension. Okay. So the Battle of Chancellor Viel. All of you see my screen, right? You both screen see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Read this and then let me know when you are finished reading. Okay. I'm going to give you some time. I'm going to give you 2 minutes to read it. Hi, Daria. Hi, Aryan. Hi, Huria.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening. Good evening. We are doing comprehension. I want you all to please read this, okay? And then we'll shift to the questions.
Know this actual story, ma'am.
You know this story?
Yes, ma'am.
Good.
Ma'am, this was the American Civil War
Okay.
between
Okay.
Union led by the Abraham Lincoln and the Confederates.
You have nice interest in history, I guess, right?
Used to, ma'am, not now.
Not now?
No.
Used to. Why
Yes.
not now?
Ma'am, I'm nowadays more interested in science and
Your interest is in
science.
science. Science is also good.
Ma'am,
You
actually,
yeah.
that time it was a war of slavery, ma'am. That time
Okay.
those white natives, ma'am, they enslaved the black Africans.
And against the black. There was a lot of racial discrimination problem in America at that time.
Yes,
So in
ma'am.
Virginia this took place. Yeah. So all of you finished reading. Jitendra, you've just joined.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we are doing a comprehension and there is a small passage here and I want you all to please read it. I'm going to give you 1 minute, okay? And then we'll head towards the questions. All of you have finished reading? Should I scroll down for the questions? Okay, we have two questions here. Okay, who's going to give me the answer for the first one? Based on information in this passage, it can be concluded that Hooker lost the battle of Chancellorsville mostly because of his. Now, give me the answer, Aryan.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the answer for the first one, for the first question?
C, overconfidence.
See, overconfidence. Good. Okay, so throughout the passage, the author portrays the Hooker as very confident. He has overconfidence. Okay, now how do we find out that? You can see in the paragraph 3, the author tells us that even though the Union Army was weakened and demoralized, Hooker proclaimed, "My plans are perfect. Okay, and when I start to carry them out, may God have mercy on Bobby Lee, for I shall have done." Then the author say, author asks, why, aside from the prosperity for narcissism, was Hooker so confident? So this means that he was overconfident. He was overconfident. Okay, so he was overconfident, is the answer. In the second one, the contrast between Lee and Hooker in paragraph 2 is intended to, what is the answer? Do you all want to read the paragraph 2 again? I'm going to the paragraph 2. Okay. Here's the paragraph. This is the paragraph two. In appearance, personality, and lifestyle, these men were nearly perfect opposites. Lee, an older man in poor health with a gray beard, had a somber, measured demeanor. Hooker was a blonde, strapping young man whose vanity over his appearance was but one aspect of his egotism. Whereas Lee was devout and principled, Hooker was known for his rollicking enjoyment of both women and whiskey. Okay, so now let's go to the second question. The contrast between Lee and Hooker in paragraph two is intended to, one, showcase the different backgrounds and personality histories of these two enemy soldiers, provide support for the idea that Lee was a more virtuous person than Hooker and therefore a better military commander, prove that two men with very different values could end up in similar positions of power, suggest that if Hooker had more devoid and principle, he might not have been outwitted by Lee, imply that these men fundamentally differed in their approaches to nearly everything, including battle. What is the correct answer? You tell me, detailed. A, B, C,
मैम
D, E.
ए
A. A is the wrong answer. Okay. Anybody else wants to try? Sumuk?
यस मैम
Make a wild guess.
मैम सी
See, no.
बी
B A F E D N E. What? Shravan?
बी बी
E. What do you say? E or
नो
B?
मैम बी बी बी
B. Okay, B is also the wrong answer. It is.
मैम ई
Ma'am, is it D?
ई
Yeah, E is the right answer.
ई
Why E is the right answer? Okay, now the author claiming that in defense, their in appearance, personality, and lifestyle, these men are nearly perfect opposites, right? Whereas the author portrays Lee as somber, measured, devout, and principled. The author describes Hooker as blonde and strappy and full of vanity and egotism. So later in the passage, the author describes that how the two men differed in their approach into the battle. So, and also in the final paragraph, the author writes that Hooker, supremely confident, became convinced that Lee had no choice but to retreat and began to ignore reality. So, he is that implies that these are fundamentally differed and their approaches to nearly everything, including the battle. Okay, let's take up the third question. In paragraph three, the author quotes Hooker as saying, "My plans are perfect, and when I start to carry them out, my God have mercy on Bobby Lee, for I shall have none," because he will have no mercy. The author most likely includes this quote in order to, there are choices A, B, C, D, E. Okay. Read the question well, and then I will take you to paragraph three. You can read the paragraph three. Okay. A demonstrated Hooker's belief in his own infallibility. Provide an example on the way language has changed since 1863. Reveal that Hooker was a deeply religious man in spite of his lifestyle. Foreshadow Hooker's defeat at the hands of Lee's army. Portray Hooker as a merciless general who was compelled by his hatred of Lee. Okay. Let me take you to the third paragraph. Okay, now this is the third paragraph. Despite the fact that the Confederacy had won the last four major battles and the Union soldiers are famished. Famished means very hungry, exhausted, and demoralized. Okay. Hooker proclaimed, "My plans are perfect. In spite, although his army is weak. Okay, my plans are perfect. And when I start to carry them out, my God have mercy on Bobby Lee, for I shall have none." Why, aside from a propensity of for narcissism, why was Hooker so confident? You'll understand propensity and narcissism, right? What is a narcissist person? Anybody can tell me? Anybody know, has any idea what is a narcissist person?
An obsessed person.
Yes, he is an obsessed person. It is kind of a psychological disorder, you can say. This person, he lives in a delusional life, right? He, in case, many narcissism are people who are overconfident. They are that I cannot be wrong. If anything happens wrong, it is the other person's fault. They try and put the blame on another person, the person in front of them, and they portray that they have done nothing wrong, and whatever bad is happening is because of what another person. So let's go back to the third question. So what is the answer? Anybody?
Ma'am, D.
What do you say? D. D is wrong.
Ma'am, A.
Yeah, it is A. Good. Demonstrate Hooker's belief in his own infallibility. Okay, he is. He has no idea that he is going to. He has a capacity to fail because he is not seeing the fact that his army is famished, he is demoralized and weak. Okay. When based on the use in paragraph 3, it can be inferred from the word propensity belongs to which of the following word groups? Okay. So this is a based this is a question based on vocabulary. Propensity means which word group does it belong to? Fondness, partiality, affection, flaw, fault, shortcoming, distaste, aversion, dissatisfaction, tendency, inclination, predisposition, confidence, self-assurance, certitude. Anybody has any idea? Korea, any idea? Let's just read the question. It is there in paragraph 3. Let's just read the sentence. You will get a better idea. Okay. Okay. For I shall have none. Why, aside from a propensity for narcissism, was Hooker so confident? Why, aside from a propensity for narcissism, was Hooker so confident? Let's go back to the question. Based on its use in paragraph 3, it can be inferred that the word propensity belongs to which of the following word groups? Uriya, any guess? Dharia? It's okay if you are wrong. We can always go through it. Okay, the answer is A, fine. The author does not discuss how language has changed since 1863. Okay, so the author is saying my plans are perfect and when I carry them out, may God have mercy on Bobby Lee, for I shall have none. To understand why the author most likely includes this quote, we need to know the context of the quote in the beginning of the paragraph 3. The author notes that Hooker says his plans are perfect in spite of the fact that his troops are famished, exhausted, and demoralized. This means that Hooker is confident that his plans will be successful even though his army is weak. Okay, now in the final sentence of the paragraph 3, the author says, why, aside from the propensity of narcissism, was Hooker so confident? So this tells us that the quote is intended to show how confident Hooker was in his belief that he would win. So this means that the author most likely includes this quote to demonstrate Hooker's belief in his own infallibility. Therefore, A is correct. Okay? Therefore, A is correct. Okay, now how many men did Hooker's position behind Lee's army? We can find this in the paragraph. You see the paragraph? And then now tell me the answer. 61,000, 70,000, 73,000, 1,34,000, 1,58,000. Okay, now we're going to have here, we have Hooker had used spies, analysts, and even hot air balloons to compile a vast amount of intelligence about Lee's army. Okay, he had discerned, for example, that Lee had only 61,000 men to Hooker's own, Hooker's own 1,34,000. Buoyed upon him by his superior numbers, Hooker covertly moved 70,000 of his men 15 miles up and across the river, and then ordered them to sneak back down to position themselves behind Lee's army in effect. So, how many men did Hooker have? Somebody give me an answer. Sumuk. Sitri, you have joined now? Oh, okay. Huria says B. 70,000. Okay. 70,000 is the right answer. Okay, it is there in the paragraph. So 61,000 was Lee's army. Okay, so okay, as used in the paragraph 4, buoyed most nearly means strengthened, anchored, floated, sharpened, heartened. Somebody give me the answer. See. उड़िया से सी फ्लोटेड, हियर इन दिस पैराग्राफ इट मीन्स हार्टेड. ओके ओके नो बॉय बी यू ओ वाई इज अ वर्ब. ओके इट मीन्स टू रेज द स्पिरिट्स ऑफ, ओके दैट यू कैन से हार्टन और कैन से बॉस्ट और यू कैन से सपोर्ट. सो ही सपोर्टेड, ही रेज द स्पिरिट्स ऑफ, ही हार्टेड. ओके ओके लेट्स गो टू द सेवेंथ क्वेश्चन. अकॉर्डिंग टू द ऑथर, हुकर एडवांटेजेस गोइंग टू द बैटल ऑफ चैंसलर रॉयल इंक्लूडेड नंबर्स पोजिशन स्ट्रेटजी. ओके व्हाट इज द आंसर? यू कैन से ए बी सी डी ई. ओके नाउ टू आंसर दिस डिटेल्ड क्वेश्चन करेक्टली वी नीड टू फाइंड वेयर द ऑथर डिस्कसेस हुकर्स प्लान एंड एडवांटेजेस गोइंग इनटू द बैटल इन द पैसेज. ओके अ गुड वे टू डू दिस इज टू स्कैन द टॉपिक सेंटेंसेस ऑफ ईच पैराग्राफ. ओके नाउ सिंस द सेंटेंस विल लाइकली टेल अस व्हाट इंफॉर्मेशन कैन बी फाउंड इन द रेस्ट ऑफ द पैराग्राफ, द टॉपिक सेंटेंस ऑफ पैराग्राफ 4 रीड हुकर हैड यूज्ड स्पाइस एनालिस्ट and even hot air balloons to compile a vast amount of intelligence about Lee's armies. This lets us know that the details we are looking for can likely be found in paragraph 4. Now in paragraph 4, the author writes that Hooker has discerned that Lee had only 61,000 men to Hooker's own 134,000 and that Hooker has buoyed his by his superior numbers. Since Hooker had over twice as many as Lee, this tells us that Hooker's advantages going into the battle include numbers. This supports option one in paragraph four. We learn that Hooker covertly moved 70,000 of his men 15 miles up and across the river and then ordered them to sneak back down to position themselves behind Lee's army. In effect, Hooker had cut off the Confederate soldiers in front and behind, and they were trapped. Okay, so we will just understand that he had all these strategies. So it was C one, and he had numbers and he had position, but he had failed in his strategy because he failed to recognize that his weak, that his army was weak. Okay. Let's do it. As used in paragraph 4, Boyd most nearly means dialogue. Specifically, we have done Boyd. In this passage here, to continue with the following, would most likely be the first sentence of the next paragraph. Okay, we'll do one thing. We'll just this is very complicated passage. We'll do one thing. We'll shift to our tenses. Okay. Fine. So all of you were there. We did tenses, and you know we have three main tenses. Okay, that is the present tense. We have the past tense, and we have the future tense. Okay, now we have and we have assertive, we have negative, and we have interrogative. We have negative interrogative also. Okay, next we have after present tense, we have further categories. We have continuous, okay, and then we have perfect, okay, and then we have perfect continuous. Okay, so this is there. Like, let me tell you, we have simple, okay, and then we have continuous, and then we have Perfect. And then we have perfect continuous. All of you all understand so far, right? Yeah, Rizwana, you understand so far? So this is there for present. This is there for past and also for future. So we have simple present, we have simple continuous, we have simple, we have present perfect, we have present perfect continuous. We have past simple, we have past continuous, we have past perfect, we have past perfect continuous. We have future simple, we have future continuous, we have future perfect, we have future perfect continuous. Okay. Now, what is, let me in a simple sentence, let me tell you all what is tense about. Tense is all about a timeline. Okay. Tense is all about a timeline. Let me tell you all. So, in case we have a timeline, so let me give you a timeline for simple present. Okay, so we have a timeline that is, let me tell you all timeline. In case it's a straight line here, okay, and we have here, we have the future, and here we have the past, okay, and here we are here in the present. Okay, so a simple present is somewhere where we are here in the present. Okay, now when we are going to talk about what is a simple present, so if simple present talks about repeated action, you can say a daily routine. I go for a walk in the morning. I go for a walk in the morning. What do you understand by this? This is a repeated action, right, Rizwana? Yes or no? Or you can say this is a repeated action, or you can say this is a generalization. Okay, the sun rises in the east. The sun rises in the east. This is also generalized. It will not rise in one single day. It will not rise yesterday. You cannot say the sun rises in the east yesterday, right? Or the sun will rise in the east tomorrow, right? We are not going to say, because this is something that is repeated and something that is generalized. Okay. Now we have, in the next, we have, you all understand the timeline of this simple present. Aryan?
Yes, ma'am.
You all understand the timeline?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So next we are going to do present continuous. Okay. Now the timeline, understand the timeline here. We have a straight line in case we have the future here, and we have the past here, right? This is the past and this is the future. Okay, now we have the present here. Okay, now in present continuous, what is happening? The action is taken place somewhere in the past, okay? And it is continuing in the just present. Mean present means not just at this moment. A few, it could continue for a few hours. It could continue for some time more further. Okay. Now, what is happen? What is here? Action is happening now. Okay, action is happening around now. Yeah, mean now at this present, or it could be in some hours later. Fine. So this is present continuous, and you know we are going to add always ing to it. Right? Can somebody give me an sentence of present continuous? Let me give you an example. I am walking. Yeah. Any other sentence? Anybody has any idea for any other sentence? Okay, everybody understand present continuous. When this is present continuous happening on a timeline chart? Fine. I'm going to do one thing. I have this question here that is simple. Progressive means continuous. Okay, and I will give this question to all of you all. Fine. And we will continue tenses next time. Fine. Anybody has any question? We are about to run out of time, so I think that's why I stopped. So, anybody has any question regarding tenses? No? Fine, then I will end the question, end the session now. Fine. And please join again. Those who are in 10th, please join for the social studies classes. Okay.
Ma'am, when is the social class?
It is in 7:10.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Bye.